Before thousands of years, our saints and sadhus thought of having a tomb in the triangular form with a particular measurement. And that measurement ultimately resulted into pyramid. Now these pyramids are not popular in India. They are only tombs. And the houses created, some of them are having roofs like pyramids. But in Egypt, they thought over it very deeply that what is this triangular shape and square at the bottom and what are the measurements? And they came to know that under this tomb, you can keep the things fresh for a long, long time. In India, the thought was different. When you go to a temple and sit particularly at a particular place, exactly under the pyramid where the tomb is there, you'll be lost in no time in meditation. You'll be full of positive thoughts, creative thoughts, and peace of mind. But very few people know about it. They visit the temples, take a round here and there, just make some pranam wherever they are standing, as if they are getting a chance to see the idol of the Lord. They don't do anything more than that. But I have practiced this. I go to places where the temples are very empty, villages where visitors are very few. Hardly a few visitors are there in the morning and in the evening. Otherwise, throughout the day, the whole temple is empty. Now you go there and find out the exact place where you should sit, center of the pyramid. And you sit there and then get absorbed into meditation and japa, etc. You will be lost, completely lost. You will not know what the time is and where you are and what you are and what purpose you have come here. Now these pyramids were created in India for the purpose of peace of mind. You go to temple for what? For getting positive thoughts, get rid or release from negative thoughts, bad thoughts, etc. And to have creative thoughts, something to do in life, grow in life, make a progress in life, etc. Now these pyramids in Egypt, they are known as mummies. They keep the dead bodies along with the wealth of the person who is kept there. Throughout the history, they are keeping the bodies there under the mummies. The word mummy is used by us also in India for calling our mother as mummy. We don't know how that is developed from English language and American language. And why they call mummy, I don't know. Our own word, ma, full of significance. It has deep meaning, the mother or the ma. Mother is something different. M and other, that is mother. Man and other, his spouse, that is mother. From that the word has come as short form, mummy. But our own word in Sanskrit language is ma. The child, first word spoken by any child is ma. And Sanskrit language is a language in which every syllable has a meaning. Ka has a meaning, kha has a meaning, cha has a meaning, ta has a meaning. And all the names of gods are taken out only according to that, by calculations of syllables. The word ma is used in mantras. Ma comes up every now and then. People make the japas with the addition of ma, and ma is reliever of your difficulties and your miseries. The child shouts ma only when the difficulty is there or the misery is there, when the trouble is there. Now these mummies, they are very popular in Egypt. In other countries, they don't make use of these pyramids for keeping dead bodies. But in Egypt, they are still there for thousands of years. Sikandar, when he died, he spoke these words, Mara marana vakte, milkat badi ahi laav jo, mari nanami saath, milkat badi ahi daat jo. When I die, along with my body, bring all my wealth along with me. And keep it along with me when you keep me under the pyramid. Now, a lot of wealth is lying in the pyramids. Lots of jewelry and this and that. And some people try to break the pyramids, enter the pyramids, and rob the material lying within it. Many of them died within. Some of them who came out running, as if they are running from fire, as if they have seen some ghost, and they became mad or ill forever. 18 times people tried, and perhaps many more might have tried. That is not the news, because recorded news is only 18 times. And all the 18 times people have suffered. In 8 or 9 cases, people have died within, nobody has come out. Other cases, people have come out, they are all sick and ill. Now, these pyramids have got mysterious powers. What are those powers and from where they are coming is not known to anybody. We have tried to experiment several times to find out what powers are created within the pyramid and how they are generated and how they are helping the people. Pyramid is a great help in your life. It brings lot of benefits to you. We'll come to that step by step. Now, these pyramids, the powers within are wonderful, mysterious powers. Such powers could not be created elsewhere in any other shape. Only the triangular shape in a particular way, particular measurement could only bring the results. Otherwise, all other shapes have gone failure. Secondly, people try to keep other animals in the pyramids also. And their bodies also are still fresh and fine. The soul is not there, but the dead bodies are lying there as fresh and fine. Our kings also, and our Muslim rulers and other rulers also tried to copy the pyramid, and they have found success with it. If you go to a tomb, Muslim tomb, masjid, same shape is there. If you go to a church also, same shape is there. And all these shapes are created with the purpose that powers are created within and people get the benefit of those powers. Secondly, those who created sheep, the sheep is reverse of pyramid. And the sheep is a fine piece, how it remains in the sea forever, years and years together, no problem. So that is also another mystery, how the pyramids are working in a sheep in a reverse form. Then our Indian cap, Gandhi cap, you know, there also pyramid is created. The cap is angular and two shapes are there, and the pyramid is created there. Our body also is full of pyramids. When you stand like this, you create a pyramid. When you stand like this, two pyramids are created. When you stand like this, pyramid is created. Like that, 36 pyramids are created in the human body. And they all are useful to us for creating energy in the body and getting benefit of the pyramid powers. Now, these pyramids are called in our Sanskrit language, our scripts, as the powers of Brahma. Brahma means the creator God. The whole world is created by Brahma. The ancient Hindu literature says there are three types of gods. And from that, the word God has come. First is growing, one who is creating and growing. Second is organizing, Vishnu. He is organizing the system of the whole world. Your money power, your this power, that power, administration, everything is systematized. And third is, all that which is created must destroy, otherwise there will be no place in this world. So G-O-D means growing, getting, organizing and destroying. And that's why Hindu scriptures say there are three gods, Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh. Brahma is creator, the giver, the grower. Vishnu is organizer of all systems and everything in the world, administrator, the greatest administrator. And Shankar, Mahesh, is the destroyer. He destroys everything that is created. And that must come to an end. Again, the creation is there. The creation goes on revolutionizing. This body dies, it comes out of five elements. And all those five elements again go into the five elements when you die. The body is given to the earth, either by burning it, cremation, or by keeping it under the earth, etc. Whatever the way it is done. But it goes again back to the five elements. And there are certain ways in which if you go with the asanas, then 81 type of pyramids can be created in your body. And all these are very useful to you for creating energy in the body. Now these pyramids can be used in several ways. One is preparing water out of pyramids. Boil the water. Get it cooled, not in refrigerator, natural temperature. After that, filter it, make it totally clean, and then keep it under pyramid for 2 hours to 12 hours. And you can use the metal according to your requirement. Some people say we use only copper part. That is not proper. Copper is harmful to some people, copper is useful to some people. Every metal has its own virtue, usefulness. So you should use the metal which is useful to you. Now this water, when created, can be taken by you in doses. If you make a large quantity, then you can consume water directly whenever you drink the water or cook any food, etc. But if you prepare a small quantity, one or two bottles, then take one or two spoonful water out of the bottle, add it to the glass of water which you are drinking, mix it up, and then take that. That also will give you enough energy. But if you can take fully pyramidized water, that will be very, very useful. It is also called Amrutjal. Pyramid can be prepared out of wood or plywood or fiber or glass or acrylic or board also, cardboard. But don't create pyramid out of metal. And as far as possible, don't prepare it out of iron at any time. Copper may be used. Now these pyramids have got four shapes, four sides are there. The shape is square at the bottom and triangular on four sides. This is one pyramid. I'll show you different pyramids afterwards. If you want to write the measurements, then the base should be 4, 11, 16 inches. 4 integer, 11 upon 16 inches. The side should be 4 integer 7 upon 16 inches and the height inside should be 3 inches. You can multiply that in whatever way you like. A large pyramid can be prepared for 6 feet and 3 inches base, 5 feet and 11 inches on the sides and 4 feet inside height. You can still make it larger and sit under it for meditation, etc. And you'll find great pleasure when sitting for meditation and peace of mind. Many people have got these pyramids created in their own house. They sit under the pyramid for meditation, japa, puja, etc. and worship the Lord and find virtuous benefits. These pyramids also have magnetic powers. the electricity, the universal energy, and the radio waves, etc., TV waves also, all these in the atmosphere are caught by these pyramids. But you don't get the TV program or radio program on this. They are silent. That's a different instrument. Now these pyramids are also creating powers within. And those powers, those energetic powers are flowing outside around you. Suppose you keep the pyramid on your head, then the power created there will cover your body gradually, and ultimately it will cover your aura and give it a different color, beneficial to you. It increases your immunity powers of resisting the diseases or any unwanted elements in your body. It has universal direct powers. It keeps materials fresh for a long time. If you keep your vegetables under the pyramid, they will remain fresh for a number of days. Fruits also, they'll remain fresh for a number of days. And if you keep a pyramid above your refrigerator, then all the items kept in the refrigerator will have the effect and will have great benefits. It also decreases unnecessary water element in the items kept under it. If the water increases in the vegetable or in the fruits or in the cooked food, etc., it is dangerous. It also removes fungus, does not allow fungus to be created on the food that is there for your consumption. It prevents dehydration of the items which are there under the pyramid. It also gives you a lot of concentration and one-pointedness, which is necessary for your development. It develops your progressive powers and it gives you more nutrition directly from the atmosphere and gives you protection against virus and bacteria which are creating diseases in your body. It also removes impurities in your body and the mind and your mind. One foot, then keep the vessel at 4 inches higher than the earth level. That will give you better benefit. If you keep a wooden board under the pyramid and keep the vessel above the wooden board, it will be more beneficial to you. This pyramid water can be used also for your plants. And if you are doing farming, you can use it for your trees and the growth of food, etc. You can drink pyramid water at a time in the morning. You can consume up to one full bottle. And then you can go on increasing so that you reach up to 1 kilo. You can consume the pyramid water in the evening also, or throughout the day, every 2 hours interval. If the pyramid water remains open by mistake, then don't use it, because other bacteria will make the effect on that. If you like, you can heat the pyramid water or cool it a little, not much. For injuries, if you have any burns by mistake, then apply pyramid water on the burns. Or any injury, cutting of the skin or the flesh, etc., and the blood coming out, then apply the pyramid water with a cotton gauze and brush it and massage it. Or you can take cotton cloth, not any other type of, only cotton, pure cotton. Immerse it in the water, let it wet down completely, remove the water and keep it on the body. You can use the pyramid water for taking your bath. If you cannot use so much water, then lastly after you finish your bath, take few glasses of pyramid water. In the ears if there is pain, or in the nose also, if there is pain or any trouble, then put some pyramid drops inside your ear or inside your nose, and the effect will be there. You can use pyramid waters by putting it in a tub and take a bath. You can massage your body for pain, etc., with pyramid water, or the joint pain also, pyramid water can be used. People who are suffering from intestine troubles or constipation, then they can take enema with the pyramid water and the effect will be there. Pyramid water will remain in fresh up to 24 hours. You can cure many diseases with the pyramid card. This is one pyramid, single pyramid. They come in different colors also. Then this is a pyramid with 9 pyramids. You can fix up under it. And then there are small pyramids, 9 pyramids each. You can fix up under this at the hollow place, and that will be 81. 81 plus 9, 90 plus 1, 91. Here it is fixed, one ready. One pyramid is here, 9 pyramids are inside, as I showed you, and 81 pyramids are from these 9 blocks. It makes very powerful pyramid, 91 pyramids at a time. In case of headache, keep the pyramid on the head or on the side where the pain is there. If the pain is on this side, or this side, but one end of the pyramid must come on the north. This is the north side. So one end also must come on the north side. And if you are lying down, lie down in such a way that your head goes in the north and your legs in the south. This is south, this is north. This is east, this is west. So keep it in such a way that one end or one corner will go in the north, another corner will come automatically in the south. Then for blood pressure, high or low, just keep the pyramid here on the heart and put your own hand and it will start working. Low blood pressure will become normal, high also will come down to normal. If you are having pain, if the pain is there, all the 5 fingers should be kept there on the pain. Catch the pyramid with the other hand and put the 5 fingers there on the pain, and the pain will go away. And repeat the words, the pain in my body should go away forever immediately. The pain must go away forever and immediately. If you don't use this word, pain should go away, means it will go away when the time comes. It will continue. Or pain to stop, pain will stop. As soon as you remove the hand, pain will start. So pain should go away forever immediately. And you want that, let the pain go away forever. You never want the pain to come back. Then weakness in the body. Less blood, less hemoglobin, etc. Put it on the body in such a way that your solar plexus are touching one end. Heart is touched by the other end. And your abdomen is covered, stomach is covered. Stomach creates blood and the heart takes charge of the blood created and puts it in the whole body, and the body goes on running well with the blood created. Paralysis. Suppose the paralysis of left hand is there, put it first here, or you can have more than one pyramid, put one here, put one here. Afterwards bring them here. And then heart must be taken. Paralysis means blood circulation is very less or not circulating very well in that part, and the nerves have become dead, and then to the brain. So for the part affected, paralysis, if the leg is affected, legs also, one by one, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, heart and the head. Rheumatism, people have got rheumatism on the shoulders or any other part of the body, wherever it is there, just put the pyramid, put at one end comes to the north. Then eyes trouble, if the eyes don't use the big pyramid, take the small pyramid and put the small pyramid on your eye. If both eyes are affected, put two pyramids and cover it up with your own hand. Then diabetics, keep it below the point which is there in the solar plexus and also the stomach, etc. afterwards, because the insulin must be created, and when the insulin is created, diabetes will come under control. Then piles, keep it on the back. Then waist pain, people get waist, ladies particularly, they get waist pain. Put it there like this way, on side, waist, etc., both the waist. Constipation, keep it at the bottom. Diarrhea, same way, at the bottom. Acidity, acidity is created in the stomach, so solar plexus and above that. Kidney troubles or urination troubles, keep it at the below the solar plexus, up to the bottom. Then brain swelling, catch the brain and keep it there. Or any tumor is there, keep it there, it will clear up, tumor will go out. Tuberculosis, lungs at the top. Swelling in the lungs tube, little below. Coughing, same way. Then disease of nerves, brain is affected. Ringworm or eczema or psoriasis, all the parts where the effect is there, 5 minutes each. Suppose you are getting scratching here, put it here. Scratching is here, put it here. Scratching is here, put it here. Scratching is here, put it here. Then fatness. Cover the solar plexus, one point and the bottom and the other part, or keep it in the middle. Then asthma, disease of the lung at the top. Disease of stomach, on the stomach. Then cancer, the part which is affected. If you have got cancer in the cheek, put it like this. Or if the cancer is here in the throat, put it like this. Wherever the part is affected, keep the pyramid there and put it continuously for 48 minutes minimum. And you can repeat it whenever the pain is there. Then burns, wherever the burns are there, put the pyramid there, put a bandage and above that put it, otherwise there will be irritation. Or blood flowing away from the body or injury, first clean that part, after that put a bandage with the gauze, etc., and then put the pyramid. Oozing will be there. Sleeplessness, brain. Peace of mind required. And psoriasis, another disease of the skin. Keep it at various places. In all cases, you must drink pyramid water. If you don't drink pyramid water, effect of pyramid will be much less. If you want to keep healthy, and even if you don't have any disease, then don't have the habit of using pyramid. Don't have habit of doing anything. I believe that this body should not be habituated with anything. Some people say, I go on taking vitamins every day. When they don't take vitamins, the trouble is there. Let the body remain on its natural form, with the immunity created at the highest. I know so many people who say that I don't take sugar because the sugar in my body is on the limit, on the boundary. And if I take sugar, I may get diabetics. What they are doing, they are slowly and slowly killing their immunity, their power of fighting the disease. So that should not happen. The body should not be habituated with anything. People suffering from high blood pressure, they take tablets every day, fearing that if they don't take the tablet, the high blood pressure will come up and they'll be in trouble. That should not be there. Really speaking, keep a machine in your house, measure the blood pressure, if necessary, take the tablet. Otherwise, don't take it. And form the habit of removing the tablet slowly and slowly. Get rid of the tablets as far as possible. At an older age, it's a different thing. But during young age, never form any habit of any tablets or medicine. Secondly, your thought powers will also go on increasing and becoming more and more noble. And bad thoughts will go on reducing little by little by keeping pyramid on your head. And by that, you will benefit a lot. In case of heart trouble, so many people are having heart trouble because we call a shibir where people are invited. We make them lie down on the ground with the head on the north and keep the pyramid here on the heart and then ask them to go into this mudra. Apana mudra. That helps a lot. Mudras also, various type of mudras are there. Wherever you got any pain in the body, put the pyramid there with the five fingers. As I told you earlier, that the pain should go away. Then people are suffering from various type of different diseases. Some people have got more than one disease. Then keep the pyramid at various places for minimum 7 to 10 minutes with the meditation that this disease is going away and I am getting free from this disease forever. As I told you how to put it, ears. If the trouble is there in the ears, put the pyramid on the hole of the ear. And the pain will go away. Then people have got cold. In case of cold, put the small pyramid here and one big pyramid here. Asthma, coughing, breathing trouble, etc. Lungs. Heart, take the heart. For diseases of this abdomen, put the pyramid on the abdomen, kidney, bottom part of the abdomen, joints, wherever the trouble is there with the joints, motor joints are affected, blood pressure, high or low, heart, and for peace of mind, keep your head under the pyramid and have meditation and you'll find wonders. Many people keep an easy chair in their house. And on the easy chair, they put the pyramid. When they sit down the pyramid, they sit under the pyramid. They have nice sleep, rest, meditation, etc. Some people keep the pyramid in the office also at the place where they are sitting. Exactly where they are sitting. And they find concentration, very high concentration, plus one-pointedness and decision power. So there are so many uses of the pyramid, and these pyramids can be used very well in your day-to-day life, and they don't cost much. A pyramid may cost you hardly 80 rupees, this size, the size which I have shown you. Then there are bigger pyramids and bigger pyramids available in the market, and so many things are there. plus one Mr. Jiten Bhatt. He has made experiments with Vastu Shastra and he has found enormous benefits coming out of use of pyramids in the case of Vastu. And he claims that all people who have purchased his pyramids and used them in the manner shown by him, they all become very rich and they get a lot of benefit out of pyramids. Maybe true or wrong, I don't know. Unless we go and ask the people whether they have benefit or not. But he claims that the benefit must be there. In the house also, if you keep a pyramid, the effect will be there. But if you just keep a pyramid somewhere here or there, on a table or anywhere, I don't think any effect will be there. Its usefulness should be found out. And then you should put it in action. Suppose you keep a TV in your house and keep it in a corner, what will happen? No use. But if you use it properly, after knowing where to put which program, then you will be able to listen to the programs. You will get your programs in time. So you should find out for what purpose you have purchased the pyramid. Now suppose you put a pyramid in your window or a ventilation, broadside outside and the pointed inside. It will also catch power from outside, just like exhaust fan, and add the powers in your room. Some people keep it on the door also. The power should be created. The other side should be open. Then again, there is a trouble of thefts, etc., if the doors are open. But the ventilation, you can put the pyramid without any trouble. And the room will be full of vibrations and good vibrations. Like that, many experiments are going on with every type of persons. What are the different uses of pyramid? But I have found that it can be used in any disease. Pyramids plus magnets, double benefit. Plus acupressure points, third benefit. And meditation at the time of using all these materials will be fourth benefit. In our program on divine healing, we teach you how to meditate, how to pray, and what to think. In our program on pyramids, we have shown you how to use the pyramid. Last time I showed you about magnets. Now suppose a person is suffering from depression. Pyramid is no doubt useful. But if you put the magnet inside the pyramid, with the powers going to the brain, that is red on the bottom, touching the brain or the head, and the blue on the other side. And the pyramid power going after filtering with the magnet will create excellent results. Very fast. So pyramids can be used also with the magnets. They can also be used along with acupressure points. Now the points for eyes are here, points for lungs are here. Just give the treatment, put the pyramid, put the magnet also if necessary, put other metals also necessary, and then start the treatment. It will be very, very effective. And secondly, meditation is very, very useful in all the cases. Maybe use of magnets, maybe use of pyramid, maybe use of divine healing or even acupressure. Just put the point and then pray that the patient's asthma trouble to go away immediately, patient's asthma trouble to go away immediately. This is for asthma, cold and cough. Asthma is the result of cold and cough inside the body permanently. And it makes an effect. The effect is there. So I thank you for listening to this program today. And